I just want to get the context for our viewers. What exactly is going on here? How does photons, how does ultimately light help reduce the bottlenecks in chips at the moment?
Yeah, well, first, Caroline, thanks for having us here. I'm excited to be here and talking with you. I think the way to think about this is everyone's familiar with and have been tracking all the innovations coming out and exciting applications happening in AI. But the AI application has really broken the back of existing computing infrastructure. And we've seen a lot of innovation happening on the compute side, so people like Nvidia building GPUs. And we've seen how these GPUs get deployed in huge AI data center deployments, so thousands, tens of thousands of GPUs. But you have to connect all of those GPUs together. Mm. So now we're at a point to where the bottlenecks are happening and how you connect these GPUs together and start to drive to higher performance overall systems, you know, driving model growth, more interactive AI models. And these bottlenecks right now show up as lower performance, higher costs, and drive a lot of cost pressure in the AI application and the software level that's built on top of it. So right. We're really looking to bring the optical innovation to solve that interconnect bottleneck.
How quickly are we talking about hearing in the next couple of years mass production?
Yeah, I think we're bringing a low-level innovation to the high-volume semiconductor world. And products in this space always take a few years to get to high volume, and the product cycles are a few years long. So the way to think about where we're at right now and what differentiates us is we have a chip that we ship today. So it's an optical chip. It's got 100 million transistors on it. It's got thousands of optical devices. You know, we've really brought a level of integration and performance that's never been seen before. But we're shipping in the tens of thousands of units, whereas the market demand is tens of millions. Mm. So the work that we still have to do over the next few years, along with our partners and our strategic investors, so Nvidia, AMD, Intel, but also very importantly, the high-volume CMOS manufacturers, Global Foundries, TSMC, Intel Foundry, we're working on bringing this forward and scaling it 1,000x in the next few years. So think of this as still a couple years away. Yeah.
Mark, who are you currently shipping to? In what form is it already being used?
Yeah, so we're shipping across a number of the customers that we strategically work with. And how they're using it right now is one, making sure that the core technology works. Hmm. So we've invented a new technology. And so before you commit to deploying that in high volume, you have to kick the tires and say, okay, there's some new elements here. There's innovation that we've done. Does it actually work? How is it yielding? How is it behaving in terms of reliability? And so a lot of our customers are consuming these thousands and tens of thousands of parts to really prove out that this technology is poised to scale into the millions. So that's how people are using it today.
When you think about NVIDIA, AMD, Intel, all of them fierce frenemies, in some ways work with each other, but in many ways work to compete, they're willing to all work very equally to get access to your technology?
Yeah, I think the way to think about this is everyone's realizing that a transition towards a new scale of optical technologies and optical products is very important for all of their future deployments and products. So we've always viewed this and what we're doing as a broadly deployed and ubiquitous technology. So yes, you're right. The semiconductor world is notorious for frenemy engagements. You know, your suppliers, your partners, sometimes you're competing. I think that's just how this world works. And ultimately, it rewards those who innovate generation after generation. And we're on the forefront of bringing optical innovation and optical products to the broad market. So that's how we view it, and we see our partners really working closely and well with us to realize that vision.
You came out of academia. MIT Lab was where a lot of this was born, Mark. What about the profitability, the business model for you? At what layer are you getting paid?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. Part of the innovation here is that we're bringing the power of fabless semiconductor design, which has done phenomenally well in the world of CMOS and electronics and companies like NVIDIA, AMD. But we're bringing a photonic element to that. So we get paid at the chip level. So we ship a known good optical I/O chiplet. So it's a silicon chip that we ship to our customers, and they integrate that chip into their multi-chip packages, GPUs, CPUs, in the future, switches, memory interfaces. So this really becomes a ubiquitous, largely deployed kind of proliferation of optical technologies, and we sell a chip.
And at the moment, who makes those chips is Global Foundries, Intel, and you're talking to TSMC. Will we just see all of those three be the ones that bring you to mass production by 2026?
That's right. I think the other thing to latch onto here is that the high volume leading edge foundries are getting involved. So Global Foundries, Intel Foundries, TSMC, they've all made public statements about what they're doing in photonics, and we're working closely with all of them, and we're excited about how this is coming together. And yes, we need that scale of manufacturing to deliver to the tens and hundreds of millions of units that the market is demanding a few years in the future.